Jagadoddharana adisidalle shoda Jagadoddharana.
Namaste Rahul.
Namaste Anna.
So we are going to practice Jagadoddharana, right?
Yeah.
That's going to be a big release this time. We are just going to discuss a few things about singing sangathis, improvising,
yeah.
How to improvise meaningfully instead of just being doing something musically. Okay. You know what? When it comes to sangathi singing, sangathi is nothing but in Hindustani music, I guess they call it pakad, right? See, musically you can sing lot of sangathis, but you need, as they call in spiritual arena, as they call it, vivekam, the discrimination power. You need to have that to sing sangathis too. Where to sing what,
yeah.
That is also very important. Okay, just because you can sing lot of sangathis, you can't sing so much of sangathis. Okay. I'm getting reminded of something from Viveka Chudamani of Adi Shankara. In that he says, you know, I guess 11th shloka. Chittasya shuddhaye karma natu vastu palabdhaye vastu siddhir vicharena na kinchit karma koti bhi. See, he's saying you are doing the action, any kind of action. Even singing is an action. The result is chitta shuddhi, purifying the mind, you know. But again he says, na vastu palabdhaye, you are not going to the truth through that. Chitta shuddhi is happening,
yeah.
But you are not getting atma labha. For that, vastu siddhir vicharena, you need to do self-enquiry. Then only you get to that truth. Na kinchit koti bihi. Even if you do crores of actions, you won't get
to the truth.
Okay. So it will give you chitta shuddhi. It will give you the mind purification. Okay. It will purify your mind. Just try to apply the same thing in music too.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Na kinchit koti bihi. Just because you know 10 sangathis, you can't sing, apply it for your singing. Okay. When you sing, sometimes what happens is, people say, bale bale, bale bale.
Hmm.
But have you noticed something, Rahul? When they say bale bale, that bale bale they give for brainy things.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you noticed it?
Yeah, yeah.
They give it always for brainy things. If you sing a very tough sangathi, then they say bale bale, bale bale. Okay. But this bale is always for
brainy things.
Tough sangathis. But have you noticed, if you sing something very plain, not necessarily plain, even if you are singing sangathis, a few sangathis according to the meaning, according to the word you are using there, that touches their heart, and then what happens is, like, they are not even able to say that bale bale, because they are so engrossed and they are so soaked in that, and they forget everything, no? So what will you choose? A or B? A is this brainy sangathi. B is like, which will give you peace, which will give you joy. Naturally, we need that B,
yeah.
No? Okay. So let us go through this Jagadoddharana and let us analyze a few sangathis. And let us see which is best for our recording, and accordingly we record it. Okay. So can you sing that Jagadoddharana Anupallavi once?
Jagadoddharana maganendu tiliyuta.
Okay. So this is the first sangathi. Always first sangathi is like, you know, you have to give a base, you are giving a platform. That should be very plain. Okay, you are conveying the meaning. Now, second sangati. Okay, see, this is perception. There are a lot of options to sing sangatis. Mm. Maybe you can sing 100 sangatis for the same line. Yeah. Okay. But when we present, we are just going to sing 2 or 3 sangatis, right? So how do you choose the best sangati? Okay. Now when this Jagadoddharana comes, see, in my personal experience, I've sung this at least in my life 1,000 times. Okay. 1,000 times for sure, this song. Singing this again and again and again and again, then going through the meaning, and you get engrossed in the meaning too, then what happens is new sangatis, it evolves inside your mind. Okay, it just comes into you, and that's how I'll just explain you one sangati. Okay, now sing that first sangati again.
Jagadoddharana maganendu teliyuta.
Now say jagado. Okay, jagadoddharana jagadoddharana. Now if you try to analyze this again, this is not, we are not getting into it. Okay, see, just see, Jagadoddharana neepani pamarisani niri madani madani nani sada sada pagarisa saga saga panisa panigarisa panigarisa, mixture of Mohanam and Hamsadhvani. Okay, but see, no one knows this. We are not analyzing this, or we are not doing any brainy things. That just comes. When you sing it, it is just like it does a Brahma. Okay, that's it. Now sing that.
Jagadoddharana. Jagadoddharana.
Okay. Maganindu. Suddenly, you know what? This Jagadoddharana, now you sing with all dynamics. Dynamics is very important. Volume is very important for this line. You know why? Jagadoddharana. Okay, Jagadoddharana. Have you seen one thing? Jagadoddharana means, Jagada is universe. Uddharana is, I mean, one who is a savior for that. Okay, for the world, for the entire universe. Actually, this is the same as Vishnu Sahasranama, first two namas. Om Vishwam Vishnurvashakaro. Vishwam Vishnu. Vishwam is universe. Vishnu is one who pervades everything, everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Vishwam Vishnu. Jagada Uddharana. In Bhagavad Gita also, Bhagavan says, Aham Samuddharta Bhavami. I am your savior, you know. I will save you from your samsara sagara. Okay, when he says that, this word Jagadoddharana should be with all power. Okay, now sing the same sangati with all power. Just try to sing.
Jagadoddharana.
Now, what is next word?
Maganindu.
Maganindu tiliyuta. So, this Yashoda is thinking that this Jagadoddharana Krishna
is her son.
Okay. Yeah. She doesn't know the truth. She is assuming that he is her son. Okay.
Yeah.
So now just analyze one thing. I mean, Jagadoddharana Maganindu Tiliyuta. No? See, this is like, let me tell you. How do I call you? I'll call you like, I'm calling you Rahul. So you're not hearing me, okay?
Yeah.
You're not hearing me. Then second time, how do I call you? Rahul, Kana, come here. No, I call you with more bhavam or whatever. Third time, maybe I'll scold you, whatever. Okay, let that be. So just like that, Jagadoddharana maganandu teliyuta. Okay. So, Jagadoddharana maganandu, maganandu teliyuta. Small things. Now sing this with this bhava. Jagadoddharana should be dynamics, with all dynamics. Then maganandu teliyuta should be very soft.
Jagadoddharana maganandu teliyuta. Jagadoddharana maganandu teliyuta.
So this is how you have to treat sangathis. Okay. Just because you know you can sing 10 sangathis, a musician should not sing all these sangathis and all that, because after all, the end result is you are going to touch the heart of many people if you are singing it to the world. But even if you are singing it to yourself, then it should, what it should bring to you? Chitta Shuddhi.
Peace.
Peace. It should bring peace to you first. Then only, I mean, you can give peace to the world. If you are running behind opportunities, naturally as a musician we are seeking chances, opportunities and all that. Okay. If you are running running for opportunities and doing lot of things like that, then when are you going to sing for yourself? Can you imagine, just with this sangathi, we are able to feel it. Can you imagine how Sant Purandara Dasa must have sung it? Can you imagine in what state he must have been? Now, tempo. Tempo is also very important. Tempo, choosing the tempo is very, very, very important. In a live concert, it is very, very difficult to maintain the regular tempo. Yeah. No? When we record it, we can record it in a specific tempo. Tempo, I'll tell you one best thing. Okay, I'm calling you Rahul. See, this is how I can call a name, Rahul, no? Just imagine if I call you. See, I'm seeing you after maybe 1 month. So, natural thing is like, hey Rahul, how are you? That's how I'll ask you, no?
Yeah.
If I'm asking you, like I'm seeing you, then, hey Rahul, how are you? If I'm talking to you like this, what happens? You'll think I'm mad, no? No?
No.
So, okay. Do you get my point?
Yeah.
You can't sing a Kriti in a tempo where you can't sing it in a Jagadodha. The first thing is, it's very difficult to sustain the lyrics, you know? The distance between the lyrics will be very unpleasant. At the same time, you can't rush through. Okay. So tempo is very, very important. Okay. That's a point. So Kanna, when we sing a sangathi or when we sing a line, see, basically everyone is in search of perfection. Okay. So when it comes to music also, we are trying to give our best. You know. So how do we give our best? When you sing a line, you should go through the lyrical part of it, right?
Yeah.
What is the lyric is also important. Now sing that anoraniyana mahato mahivana, that line is there, no? Now sing that line. Now sing that line with same dynamics.
Yeah.
Just sing that line.
Anoraniyana mahato mahiyana.
So anoraniyana mahato mahiyana, if you sing that in same dynamics, if you sing that in same dynamics, the meaning is smaller than the smallest, larger than the largest, larger than the infinity. In that case, what expression are you giving in that line if you are singing it in same dynamics? So just try to sing that. anoraniyana, with all softness, as they say in Western piano, pianissimo. You know that?
Yeah.
Pianissimo. Now, playing pianissimo. Then with?
Forte.
Forte. Yes. You said it. So, now try pianissimo and forte. Anoraniyana should be in pianissimo. And mahatomahiyana should be in forte. Sing.
Anoraniyana mahatomahiyana.
That's it. This is the difference. Okay. So even if you sing that next sangathi and all that. Anorani. Even if you sing that line also, sing that line also in that soft, very soft dynamics. Sing.
Anorani.
Kanan, don't give even that weight to the sangathis. Just sing it as play.
Anorani. Mahato Mahiyana.
That's it. Okay. So that's how you sing sangathis. That's how you choose tempos. After all, what are we giving to the world? The final thing is a perfect thing. Perfect thing. There is perfection. If only you give that perfection in the smallest of smallest details, just like anoraniyana. Smallest of smallest detail. Even the Bhagavan is there too, no? In the smallest details. How can you make a mistake there? How can you say that, I mean, you can't give perfection there? You should give perfection in that smallest detail. Then everything. Then what happens is, this would be like, no one will say after listening to your Jagadoddharana, no one should say bale bale. No one should say bale bale. And no one should sit and clap saying that, oh, he is singing very nice and all that. That's not your purpose, Kanna. That's not your purpose. Okay, that's not my purpose too. Our purpose as a musician is to make them see. This should touch their heart. This should touch everyone's heart. And they should forget who Rahul is. They should forget who Kuldeep is. And that particular individual should forget themselves. And they should get immersed in Lord Krishna. Okay?
Yeah.
Unless until we reach that stage, let me be very frank with you, our musicianship is, I don't know whether I can use that word, our musicianship is utter waste. There is no point in showing off what you know.
Yes.
What purpose? Okay. Let us pray to the Almighty that through this Jagadoddharana, you are going to make many, many people cry. Cry with what? Cry with inner joy. It's not craving for something else. They are crying, they should cry within. They should touch their inner core. They should touch their Bhagavan inside. Okay? So, that's our responsibility. So, now that we are going for the original recording,
we'll keep
all these points in our mind. Rahul has already learnt Jagadoddharana from his teacher. And Kalavati ma'am, my pranams to you, my humble pranams to you. Srimati Kalavati Avadhut, Rahul's regular music teacher who lives in Bangalore. Such a wonderful musician she is. All these children who are featured in Vande Guru Paramparaam are learning from other gurus. And what I'm doing is, I'm bringing them together for a divine cause. And presenting them, polishing them, you can call maybe mentoring them and giving them to the world. That's what I'm destined for.
Jagadoddharana adisidane shoda Jagadoddharana.